What is it? Chet Atkins says, howdy, howdy, everybody. This is not Chet Atkins. This is Ralph Emery along with
George Jones.
And we're here to play a few records for you and entertain you on the show, which is presented by Campo Phonique,
the Holiday Inns of America,
and Vaseline Hair Tonic. George, you doing all right?
I'm doing fine, Ralph, and this is sort of winding up a week for us, isn't it?
Sure is.
You had a wonderful time with you.
You having a good time?
I'm having a great time.
Well, George brought his own coffee, too, so he'd stay awake. Who's going to open this show?
Well, one of my favorites, Charlie Pride, and he's going to do the Mississippi Cotton Picking Delta Town.
In a Mississippi cotton picking delta town, one dusty street to walk up and down, nothing much to see but a starving hound in a Mississippi cotton picking delta town. Down in the delta where I was born, all we raised was cotton, potatoes and corn. I picked cotton till my fingers hurt, dragging a sack through that delta dirt. And I've worked hard the whole week long, picking my fingers to the blood and bone. There ain't a lot of money in a cotton bale, at least when you try to sell. In a Mississippi cotton picking delta town, one dusty street to walk up and down, nothing much to see but a starving hound in a Mississippi cotton picking delta town. On Saturday nights we'd get dressed up, catch us a ride on a pickup truck. On a gravel road it nearly strangled us, that cotton picking delta dust. We'd sit across the street on the depot porch, looking at the folks looking back at us, munching on a dust-covered ice cream cone, wondering how we'd get back home. From a Mississippi cotton picking delta town, one dusty street to walk up and down, nothing much to do but just hang around in a Mississippi cotton picking delta town. From a Mississippi cotton picking delta town, one dusty street to walk up and down, nothing much to do but just hang around in a Mississippi cotton picking delta town.
That's the longest title I think we've got currently on the records. That's Charlie Pride with Mississippi Cotton Picking Delta Town.
When a skin injury makes your child cry out in pain,
ow, it hurts,
remember Campho Phonique. Campho Phonique is the multi-purpose family medication that instantly stops the pain of minor cuts, scrapes, burns, even cold sores and fever blisters. Campho Phonique gently penetrates skin injuries to kill germs, protect against infection, helps nature heal skin injuries. Campho Phonique, the penetrating first aid medication, stops pain instantly. Campho Phonique.
Together time, a time to spend, enjoying life, good food and friends. Get out and get together, where the good times all begin. Together with you, together with friends, at Holiday Inn.
The next time you're dining out, get together with Holiday Inn. Good food, good friends, together.
My guest is George Jones. George, I wanted to ask you about Hank Williams. Tammy told me that he was one of your early idols, and I went on to ask her if you knew Hank Williams, and you can give me the answer to that.
Ralph, I was in Beaumont, Texas, back during his heyday, when he was really starting off big. I guess I was 17 years old, something like that, and I had a radio. Well, it wasn't my show. It was another couple's radio show in the afternoon around 4 o'clock, and Hank Williams was appearing in town that night at what we call the Blue Jean Club out on the Port Arthur Highway. And Neville Powell was a very good friend of He was a disc jockey, and he was a very good friend of Hank Williams back at that time on KRIC in Beaumont. And we had this afternoon show, so he had Hank to come by that afternoon before his dance that night and do a song on our show. And the song he did was Wedding Bells. It had just been released. And I played electric guitar when I first started off with this man and wife team. And I had it all figured out. I knew he was going to come by. And I'd already learned Wedding Bells, and I sung it at some places already. And I knew it well, and I had it all, my part, figured out on the guitar. He gets up to the microphone with his guitar. He made me mad. He didn't let me kick it off. I done had that all figured out. I wanted to kick it off. So he started just singing it cold, you know. So, and when he started singing, I loved his singing so much, and I was so dumbfounded that I never hit one note on that guitar. From the time he started to the time he finished, my fingers just froze to the neck of the guitar. And that's in a small summary of just how much he meant to me.
Do you recall anything he said to you?
Well, we had a little talk, you know. I was wanting to get started in the business, and the couple that was with me was talking with him too, and told him that I was a big fan of Roy Acuff's and him. And he got to telling me that he tried to sing like Roy Acuff when he first started, and that he found out that they already had one Roy Acuff. What they needed now was, as far as he was concerned, was Hank Williams. So he started singing like Hank Williams and started doing all right for himself. I said, well, maybe I better quit trying to sing like you and Roy Acuff and try to sound like my own self. So he gave me a pretty good tip, and this is what I did.
But you got all shook up when he came.
But I really froze.
George, you've got, unless I'm wrong, you've got two albums out in tribute to Hank Williams.
Right. Back when I was on the Mercury label, I did my first album of Hank Williams songs, George Jones Salutes Hank Williams. And this was one of the biggest thrills of my career of recording, because it's something I'd wanted to do even sooner than I did it. But they finally let me do it, It sold real good for me.
Can you still buy these albums? You did another one, too, on another label.
Right, and later on, after I moved from Mercury to United Artists, I did another album of Hank Williams songs. And, Ralph, I'm not sure that... I don't believe they're still on the market.
I noticed, too, cut one, side one on one of these albums is Wedding Bells.
Right. I had to get that in.
Did you freeze up again?
Almost.
George, what do you want to play out of this? We'll play one out of your first album, which is George Jones Salutes Hank Williams.
Well, it's hard to pick one that I like the best, because Hank Williams didn't put out a song I didn't like. But I think we might have selected half as much.
If you love me half as much as I loved you, you wouldn't worry me half as much as you do. You're nice to me when there's no one else around. You only build me up to let me down. If you missed me half as much as I missed you, you wouldn't stay away half as much as you do. I know that I would never be this blue if you only loved me half as much as I loved you. If you loved me half as much as I loved you, you wouldn't worry me half as much as you do. You're nice to me when there's no one else around. You only build me up to let me down. If you missed me half as much as I missed you, you wouldn't stay away half as much as you do. I know that I
would never be this blue. If you only loved me half as much as I loved you.
George, I just wondered one other thing about singing the Hank Williams hits. Do you think when you got into this session that you subconsciously tried to sing like Hank?
I'm afraid so.
When I first heard you...
Once you get into one of his songs, it just automatically happens.
See, I haven't heard this album in years. I just dug it out for this show so we could talk about it. But as I remember years ago listening to it, you seemed to phrase like Hank Williams.
Right. I used pretty much the same arrangements as Hank did in his music lineup. I used the fiddle and the steel guitar and featured them mostly, like Hank did on his records.
Did you go out to see him that night at that club?
I'm afraid so.
All right, you've heard George Jones, and a salute to Hank Williams singing Half as Much. You know, George, do you know Mac McGahey?
I sure do. That old boy, he saws a pretty good fiddle.
Yeah, he's got a new record out, and Mac McGahey is the fiddling, dancing, happy-looking fella you see on the Porter Wagon.
Yeah, he's that show now. He puts on the show for him.
And he can dance and fiddle at the same time.
I don't know how he does that.
But he's a very lively part of that show, and I guess Porter might have had something to do with this. This is an RCA record.
Right.
And this is a pretty good arrangement, too. Well, this features Mac McGahey doing an old song that you've heard maybe 1,000 times or more, but maybe you haven't heard it quite like this. It's an old song called Little Liza Jane. That's fiddling Mac McGahey, who many of you have seen on television via the Porter Wagoner show, or maybe if you've seen his show in person, you've seen him live on the stage. Fiddling Mac McGahey doing Little Liza Jane.
This is Marty Robbins for Vaseline Hair Tonic. Today I've got a word for you wives. Now, if that man of yours has started losing some hair, well, there's nothing going to stop it. But you can help him take care of his hair while it's there with Vaseline Hair Tonic. It conditions and moisturizes the scalp while it grooms the hair, so it feels good and looks good, too. You tell him Marty Robbins says.
Take good care of your hair while it's there with Vaseline Hair Tonic.
Together time, a time to spend enjoying life. Where the good times all begin. Together with you, together with friends at Holiday Inn.
The next time you're dining out, get together with Holiday Inn. Good food, good friends, together.
George, I suppose over the years, if you want to refer to this business as competition, one of your biggest competitors has been Marty Robbins.
I'm afraid so. That old boy's had some records.
And he's been making them just a little longer than you have.
You know what I love to hear him sing more than anything?
What's
that?
That's
them Hawaiian type songs.
Do you really? I know he made an album
about Leilani, you know, and I believe it was it
Sweet Leilani?
Sweet Leilani.
Yeah.
And when he does that, throws that little yodel in his voice there, it just tears me up.
But I was thinking that all the years you've been making records, he's been in there somewhere in the same chart with some kind of song.
He sure has. He certainly has.
And this is the latest Bomarty Robbins, who sings a lot on this show, singing Take Good Care of Your Hair While It's There. He's going to switch off of that now and sing Two Gun Daddy.
My friends call me Two Gun. I answer when they call. My friends call me Two Gun. I answer when they call. I got one in my boot top, one in my overalls. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Well, I've rode me some freight trains, I've rode some aeroplanes. I've rode some freight trains, I've rode some aeroplanes. I don't care how I travel, I get there just the same. Give me water when I'm thirsty, a bottle when I'm dry. Water when I'm thirsty, a bottle when I'm dry. Play me some sad, sad music when I want to cry. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do and it works every time. I got me a good line, it works every time. When I start to use it, women all stand in line. You may think I'm lying, what I say ain't true. You may think I'm lying, what I say ain't true. If you don't believe me, woman, let me try my line on you.
That's the Teardrop. We used to call him that because...
Mr. Teardrop.
Yeah, you remember that
right,
record?
Right, sure did.
He used to sing a song called Hey There, Mr. Teardrop. Marty Robbins doing Two Gun Daddy. There's only one magazine in the world where in one issue you're able to bone up on Waylon Jennings' backstage life. Johnny Cash's views on the new direction his music is taking. The lowdown on the American Song Festival. Kitty Wells' life story. Olivia Newton-John's impressions of America. Country views on sexy lyrics plus news and reviews on George Jones, Dolly Parton, Georgia Rockabilly, Hayride USA, Conway Twitty, Jeannie C. Riley, Hank Snow, Tom T. Hall, and the Wheeling Truckers Jamboree in living color. All in country. Country Music Magazine's current issue. Subscribe now for 1 year and you'll receive absolutely free The Best of Country Music Volume 1, a 128-page book loaded with exciting articles and photographs of the greats of country music. Just send $7 or your name and address, no money, and Country Music Magazine will bill you later. Send to Country Music Magazine, care of the Ralph Emery Show, Box 61, Nashville, Tennessee. All right, George, I thought we'd bring on Miss Tammy to help you out. This is an old Red Lane song. Well, not too old in terms of years, but I thought this was a great record.
Well, thank you. We were doing an album when we cut this, and I was telling you a little earlier, a while ago, Ralph, that we were considering it as a single. Of course, Red Lane got did a fine job on it and got a lot of play. And we were a little concerned about whether if we should release it or not. And then about the time that while we were studying the situation over, well, Johnny Cash brought it out with the Carter family and had a real good record on it. So we put it out, saved it and put it out in an album.
It's called The World Needs a Melody.
Fine song.
The world needs a tune that it can hum, hum. The world needs a guitar that it can strum. The world needs a melody that it can sing, 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 sing. Let's all sing together in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore together.
The world needs a bell that it can chime. Chime, 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 chime. The world needs a drum to keep the time. The world needs a melody that can sing,
sing, sing, sing, sing. Let's all sing together. Gonna lay down my burden down by the riverside. Together. The world needs a reason to clap its hands. Give us that old-time religion. Give us that old-time religion. Together. In the sweet.
Give us that old-time religion.
Don't lay down our burden.
In the sweet.
Give us that old-time religion.
Don't lay down our burden.
Together.
That's a good record, George. George and Miss Tammy doing The World Needs a Melody. You're listening to The Ralph Emery Show, and my guest this week, one of the greats in country music, George Jones. And we'll get back to George in a moment. Right now, we're going to bring out somebody just a little prettier than he is. This is Tanya's sister, Miss, you know her? LaCosta?
You know, I think I met her one time, just real brief, and very pretty, a lot like Tanya.
She sure does.
Baby, my love train's coming. It's really on fire and humming. I've got a special seat that I've saved just for you. Your ticket is paid and I'm ready. Get aboard and you know, baby, I've got a train load of loving waiting for you. This ride is smooth and easy, but I know it's sure gonna please ya. You're going on a trip you've never been before. We'll do things you've never dreamed of.
on the train that's bound for true love.
And you know that's what everybody's looking for. Get on my love train and ride by my side.
'Cause you'll find that nothing is better than my loving is what you've been looking for. So let me love you forever. Get on my love train and ride by my side. Get on my love train and ride. This ride is smooth and easy. Well, I know it's sure gonna please ya. You're going on a trip you've never been before. We'll do things you never dreamed of on the train that's bound for true love.
And you know that's what everybody's looking for. Get on my love train and ride by my side.
'Cause you'll find that nothing is better than my loving. What you've been looking for. So let me love you forever.
Get on my love train and ride by my side. Get on my love train and ride. Get on my love train and ride.
That's La Costa. I think it's La Costa Darrow, but she just uses the name La Costa, singing Get On My Love Train. George, I want to talk about some of your old duets for a moment. You used to make records with Gene Pitney, didn't you?
I sure did.
Was this, I don't know whether many people remember this, but Gene Pitney was a big rock act. I always thought that was a peculiar combination, the big rock act with the big country act.
Ralph, this is when I first moved from United Artists Records to MusiCorps, and Gene Pitney was on MusiCorps, and at the time he was about the hottest thing going in that field overseas, and they thought it really might be something, you know. He loves country music, always has, and of course he never sung country, and he always wanted to do a country album, so they said, well, if you want to do a country album, why don't you do one with George Jones, since he's just signed with the label. So that's what we done, and we did two albums together, and the first album was a real good seller for us.
I know. Now, this next song we're going to play by you, you did it as a duet with him, Love Bug?
Right.
And you did two albums. Was this back when he was so hot and singing? He used to sing The Man Who Shot Liberty Valance and
right,
and all
right,
those songs.
Right.
I heard one time he owned a chemical company. Is that right?
I heard that too, but I don't believe it was true.
Okay. just got to check these things out. George, what do you want to say about The Love Bug?
Well, The Love Bug was a record that I came out with. I believe it was the very next record after Race Is On. I was trying to get another up-tempo thing going, and it wasn't quite as big as Race Is On. Wayne Kemp wrote the song, a fine singer in his own right. I believe he records for the MCA people.
That's right. He wrote this?
I believe he did, the best I remember. And so we did it, and I recorded about three different times, and it still didn't really come off the way I wanted it to, but the last time we thought it was good enough, so we put it out.
You know what's strange about this? I just noticed something. This record is exactly the same time as The Race Is On.
Is it really?
2 minutes and 3 seconds.
Well, I never noticed that before.
So if you were trying to get something just like it, you'd doggone
it. Well, maybe that's the reason it didn't sell as good. it was the same length of time there. Well, I never noticed that.
Well, I was ruling the roost and I had all the chicks to myself. And then suddenly it happened, a funny little feeling I felt. Yeah, I tried to outrun it, but it finally caught up with me. But how could she? Oh, that little bitty teeny weeny thing they call the love bug. Nobody's ever seen it, but it's got the whole world shook up. It all started with a little bitty kiss and a hug.
It's a little bitty teeny weeny thing they call the love bug. That I had me a pretty good style. I lost that race by a good old country mile. Yeah, I was walking all around with my head held way up high. And then it fooled me, hit me, really took me by surprise. Oh, that little bitty teeny weeny thing they call the love bug. Nobody's ever seen it but stop the whole world shook up. It all started with a little bitty kiss and a hug. It's a little bitty teeny weeny thing they call the love bug. It's a little bitty teeny weeny thing they call the love bug.
That's our guest, George Jones. George singing the love bug.
Together time, a time to spend. Enjoying life, good food and friends. Get out and get together, where the good times all begin. Together with you, together with friends, and Holiday Inn.
The next time you're dining out, get together with Holiday Inn. Good food, good friends, together.
So he said, if you can, I can. Ouch! My lips hurt when I laugh.
Why?
This cold sore splits open.
Camphophonique stops that pain. It lubricates and softens cold sores and fever blisters to help prevent painful cracking. Gently penetrates into and under sores to help them heal quickly.
I'd like that.
Camphophonique for cold sores and fever blisters. Stops pain fast and helps speed healing. Camphophonique.
George, on this show, because she was on last week, I haven't talked a whole lot about Tammy. But you and Tammy have a pretty good marriage going.
We sure do, Ralph. It's just full of love.
And got a whole house full of kids out there. I think she mentioned between the two of you have 7 children.
Right.
And I guess you've been married now, what, 6 years?
Yes, that's right.
When's your anniversary, George?
The 22nd of August. Hey, we just had it.
That was the 6th.
Right.
Do you recall the first time you ever met Tammy?
Boy, she'll kill me for that, won't she? She came into the studio. I believe I seen her in the studio when I was recording one of her songs, Apartment Number 9. But she says I didn't speak to her.
Oh?
Unless it was just high or something, you know. And
what'd you meet through Billy Sherrill, your A&R man?
No, we worked a few shows together where I really got to know her.
She was a big fan of yours, I remember.
I was a big fan of hers too.
So you were well aware of her records.
Right, I sure was.
Think this is gonna be a problem?
I thought she was the singingest thing I'd ever heard in a long time.
Well, I just wondered if it was difficult because of contracts for the two of you to finally get together on the same record label.
It was very difficult for the first couple of years. It took a lot of doing and a lot of deal swinging and what have you. It took us 2 years to finally talk both labels into letting us do the first album that we did together. And then got Columbia to buy out my contract, the remaining of my contract from Music Corps. And
so you went to her label.
And finally got with where I was supposed to be there, you know.
She's the boss?
She's the boss.
Yeah. And you notice she didn't go to your label.
That's
you
right. I went to hers. And it cost me a gob of money.
Here is Miss Donna Fargo on a beautiful tribute to
I
the...
love this thing,
you
Ralph.
Like this?
I got to throw that in. I just heard it today for my first time. It's a brand new record, like
right.
You were saying, and I really love it. I think it's going to really be a big thing for Donna.
It's a beautiful tribute to this country.
Sure is.
I work in your ear.
traveled your highways today. Used a creek and a rainbow for road now, and a tree for chapel to pray. And I'm so proud to sing your praises and to live in the land of the free. I'm just one of your children who loves you, your home, sweet home to me.
United States of America.
America. I believe in the red, white, and blue, and I thank you for all you've done for me, and I'll do my best for you.
Citizen of my country, I believe it is my duty to obey your laws, to try to be a worthy individual, a positive example, and a productive and responsible citizen, to be informed and concerned about our nation's affairs, and to voice my beliefs constructively, to practice diligently an attitude of brotherly love, and hold no hatred against anyone. And when one of my brothers makes a mistake, be he peasant or a president, I will try to treat him as I would want to be treated, with compassion and understanding. And I will continue to be proud to pay taxes for the opportunity to live in the greatest nation in the world. A nation born out of faith in God and sustained only if that faith and the support of the American people remain strong.
That's Donna Fargo on the show with U.S. of A. Yeah, I know you know this fella. You got
Freight Train.
You want to bring this record on?
I'd love to. I love this thing. I love this fella's guitar picking. I like Jerry Reed's picking, and I like Merle Travis's picking. But especially on this one particular thing, you can't hardly touch Chet Atkins on any of it, but this is exceptionally good, I think. Freight Train by Chet Atkins. Thank you.
That's Chester B., as Mr. Reed would say. Chet Atkins and Floyd Kramer takes a good ride on a piano.
He sure does.
That's Chet Atkins playing the freight train.
This is Marty Robbins for Vaseline Hair Tonic. Today I've got a word for you wives. Now, if that man of yours has started losing some hair, well, there's nothing going to stop it. But you can help him take care of his hair while it's there with Vaseline Hair Tonic. It conditions and moisturizes the scalp while it grooms the hair, so it feels good and looks good, too. You tell him Marty Robbins says.
Take good care of your hair while it's there with Vaseline Hair Tonic.
Together time, a time to spend, enjoying life, good food and friends. Get out and get together, where the good times all begin. Together with you, together with friends, at Holiday Inn.
The next time you're dining out, get together with Holiday Inn. Good food, good friends, together.
George, earlier I meant to bring up the antique cars. Have you gotten rid of your antique car collection?
When I moved from Florida back to Nashville, Ralph, I didn't have a place to keep all of them. I had about 12 to 15 of them, I guess. And I had two or three that I was real partial to. I just loved them. And I said, well, no, if I'm going to sell one, I'm just going to sell them all. And so I got rid of all of them. And Billy Sherrill, he bought a couple from me, and Glenn Sutton bought one.
What was the most exciting old car you had?
Well, my favorite, I had a T model and an A model, of course. That's usually always favorites. But my real favorite out of all of them was a 40 Lincoln Zephyr.
Did you have some cars owned by other famous people? Didn't you have a Cary Grant car?
Yeah, I had a Rolls Royce that was originally owned by Cary Grant. And
didn't you used to show these, didn't you, at your park? Didn't you show them?
Well, I showed them at the park, right? I had a museum built at the park that I kept them in. And like I say, when I moved to Nashville, though, I didn't have the building or anything to keep them in.
George, I need to break this off. I thought we would close the show with your newest record. If that's all right.
I appreciate that.
It's called The Door.
I've heard the sound of my dear old mama crying, and the sound of a train that took me off to war, and the awful sound of a thousand bombs exploding. And I wondered if I could take it anymore. There were times when they almost drove me crazy, but I did my best, I took it like a man. But who would think in my lonely room I'd hear it? The one sound in the world my heart can't stand. To hear that sound and to know it's really yours. Tear-stained eyes, I watched her walk away, and of earthquake storms, guns and wars, Lord, nothing has ever hurt me more than that lonely sound, the closing of the door. Closing off.
door.
Our guest star of the week, George Jones, and that's called The Door. George, I just found out you can talk like Donald Duck.
Yeah.
You want to tell everybody bye?
Bye-bye.
George, Ralph, I'm having you on my show this week.
My pleasure to be here, George. It was presented by...
The Holiday Inns of America.
Camphophonique.
And Vaseline Hair Tonic.
George, I appreciate very much you coming by. I've enjoyed listening
I've enjoyed it, Ralph. I've had a wonderful time with you all week, and I hope we get to do it again.
I do, too, George. I'll work on it.
I will, too.
We'll see you folks next week.